We are going to discuss about split muff coupling, design of split muff coupling. Split muff coupling is also called clamp coupling or compression coupling sometimes. So the design of split muff coupling, consists of the design of muff, key, shaft and the bolts. So you see here split muff coupling, why you are called it as split muff coupling means here we will use two half of muffs. See like this, we will use two separate muffs here. And these two separate muffs are connected by the bolts, number of bolts. So since for this purpose we will call it as split muff coupling. So two separate halves of the muffs are used here, and these are connected by the number of bolts which are inserted through the recess which are made in the muffs. So if you can observe in this side view, there are two halves of these muffs which are connected by the bolts here. So see here, in the design, I told that it consists of the design of muff, key and shaft and the bolts. So this, the design of muff, key and shaft is same as the design which we have discussed in the muff coupling. So the main concentration of design here is design of the bolts. So we directly shift the design of the bolts because we have already discussed the design of the muff part, key part and shaft part in the previous video, that is the design of the muff coupling. So here the main discussion is about the design of the bolt, finding out the diameter of the bolt. So we'll directly go to the finding out the diameter of the bolts. So here you see design of bolt here. Design of bolt. Design of bolt means, so design of the bolt. Design of bolt means finding out the diameter of the bolt. So see here, we are using two separate muffs here. These muffs are connected by the number of bolts. And if you see a cut part, so this is a cut part, and here you will insert the bolt here, or one bolt and one bolt here. And these bolts are used to connect the two separate muffs. And here we will finding out the diameter of the bolt, that is core diameter of the bolt we will find out, because this is the least diameter which is subjected to failure very easily. So suppose if you see here, this is the bolt and these are the threads which are cut on the bolt here. If you see like this, and here when you apply the force on the bolt, so this is the minimum area which is corresponding to the DC, so which can fail very easily. So when you are in the design procedure, if you find out, you can find out DC only, because you will substitute the strength criteria of the bolt, strength equation of the bolt in terms of DC only. So here you will apply strength equations of bolt in terms of DC, you will find out DC, from that you will find out the major diameter of the bolt. So see here, two parts of this muffs are connected by the number of bolts here. So this here we will insert the shaft here. So while it is rotating, these parts are trying to separate away, but that phenomenon is restricted by the bolts, because these bolts are connecting these two halves of the muffs, and which are connect, which are tightened by the nuts here. So here, because these are trying to separate away, so this phenomena is trying to create a tensile force in the bolts. So here if you see the force, tensile force which is acting on each bolt, if you see that force, you can write as tensile force on each bolt. Let us take it as small f is the notation, which is tensile force acting on the each bolt. So you can write force, you can write as stress into area. You can write stress into area. This you can write because you can write because from the basic equation, stress is equals to load by area or force by area. Here we require force means you can write force is equals to stress into area. So from that we can write this stress into area. And which kind of stress means here, because of tensile force is acting on the bolt, you have to write here tensile stress or tensile stress of the bolt and area. So because of the tensile force, see here, suppose if you see this is the bolt and this is the tensile force which is acting on each bolt. So because of this bolt, it is it will fail like this. So it will fail like this in the two parts. So this is the area which is subjected to tensile force, and that area, you know that is nothing but circular area. So this is corresponding that DC, core diameter of the bolt. So you have to take here. So you know this area you can write as pi by 4 dc square. This is the area, pi by 4 dc square. So this is the force acting on each bolt. So here we'll use total n number of bolts here to connect these two parts of the muffs here. So, and if you see a force acting on each part of the shaft, why we have to take force acting on each part of the shaft means this design of bolt is also will find out with the help by the shaft, each shaft only. So for that purpose we have to take force acting on each part of the shaft. So I told that here this is these two muffs are connected by n number of bolts. So let us find out force exerted by the bolts on each shaft. So if you take a half of a symmetry condition, so here n by 2 number of bolts are acting here, which are trying to apply force on each shaft, because total n number of bolts are used to connect two shafts. So we require force on each shaft means n by 2 number of bolts will apply force on the each shaft. So here we will take force exerted on each shaft, that is sigma t into pi by 4 into dc square into n by 2 you have to write. So this is the force exerted on the each shaft. So this is the shaft if you see. So because of this force exerted, so this shaft is shaft surface and muff surface are in contact. So because this, these bolts are trying to tighten the shaft, so there is a pressure between this shaft surface and the muff surface. So let us calculate that pressure. So let us see here, small p is the pressure acting between these two surfaces because of this force. You know pressure is equals to force by area. So see here, force is nothing but this is the force on each shaft. So that is sigma t into pi by 4 dc square into n by 2. And on which area this pressure is acting? See here, if you see, this is the muff surface and this is the shaft surface. And because of this tensile force which is applied by the bolts here, so this shaft surface is applying a force on the muff surface. And if you see that is nothing but, if you project that area, so that is the projected area here you have to take. So that is nothing but rectangle. So that area will become, this dimension will become D, and this dimension will become total L. So this, if you take total L, that will cover two shafts, but we require force on each shaft. So we have to take here L by 2. So this is the area of each shaft which is applying the force or pressure on a muff surface. So that is area here, we have to take it as L by 2 into D. So this is the pressure acting on each shaft on muff surface. So see here, the assumption here, the main assumption here is how the torque transmitted between the shaft and the muff is, to assume that the total torque is transmitted because of the frictional force only. So how the frictional force is developed here means, so this pressure is acting between these two surfaces, and also when this shaft is trying to rotate, so that pressure is responsible for the frictional force which is developing between these two surfaces. And if you write that frictional force, I can write the symbol, I can take the symbol F dash. So this is the F dash means frictional force between the shaft surface and the muff surface, which is responsible for the torque transmission. And if you write this F dash, this is the frictional force. So I told this frictional force is developed because of the pressure between the shaft and the muff surface. So here you know that simply force is equals to, you can write stress into area, or sometimes you can write pressure into area also. So see here, so this pressure will write here, and the area. Area means, see, if you are trying to find out this frictional force is because to find out the torque transmitting capacity. So that we are finding torque transmitted by the single shaft. So here, area means, this frictional force is acting throughout the circumference of the shaft and the muff surfaces. So here if you take the area, so that will become, this is, if you assume this is the diameter of the shaft, so if you see pi d into L will give the total area frictional forces acting between the surfaces. So that is nothing but, if you see here, pi d into L will give the total area where the frictional force is acting between the two shaft surfaces, but we require one shaft, so we'll take here by 2. So this is the area on which this frictional force is acting between the shaft surface and the muff surface. So, and because this is the frictional force is developed because of this pressure, and this amount of frictional force will depend upon the amount of friction between these two surfaces, that is mu. So you have to multiply with this mu here, because this mu is responsible for the frictional force developed. So if these are very rough surfaces, means they can hold up tightly, so you can get 100% frictional force, or that you can take one, or if it is only 30% friction is there or 40% friction is there, so you have to multiply here with corresponding value, that is 0.3 or 0.4, which is given in the problem. So that is the purpose we are taking here mu value. So this mu is responsible for the actual amount of force developed here. So if you write this mu and friction, we already got here, this this is pressure, we already got here. So this pressure, I can substitute here sigma t into pi by 4 dc square into n by 2 by l by 2 into d. And area, I told already, this is the area between where the frictional force is acting here. So if I write that, that is pi d into l by 2. So I can cancel this l by 2 and this d. And if I rearrange the terms, all the terms, I can write here pi square, pi into pi, pi square, and this is 4 into 2, 8 into mu into dc square into n into sigma t. So this is the frictional force acting between the surface of one shaft and the muff. So this frictional force is responsible for the torque transmission. And let us write the torque equation here. So that is, you know that torque nothing but force into radius, the basic equation. And here the force, we have to take it as frictional force, because this is the responsible for the torque transmission. So frictional force we have right here. And if you write that force once again, pi square by 8 into mu into dc square into n into sigma t, and this radius is nothing but d by 2, you know that is. So because these are force is act at the radius of d by 2 only, this frictional force is also act at the radius of d by 2. So that is, suppose if you take this capital small d here, so the force will act at this radius, so that is nothing but d by 2. So that d by 2 we have written here. So once again, if you simplify this, it is pi square by 16 into mu into dc square into n into sigma t into d. So this is the torque transmission capacity. So this torque transmitted, you can find out from the power formula which is given in the question. So that is, power is equals to 2 pi nt by 60 here, and torque is equals to 60 p by 2 pi n. So in the question, power is given and RPM is given. From that you can find out torque. The torque you substitute here. From that you can find out the DC, that is a core diameter of the bolt. After finding out the DC, you can find out the nominal diameter or major diameter of the bolt from the relations. Thank you.